A Kahuku transgender woman says she was denied a milestone moment walking with a class at her high school graduation. And now a petition is spreading online urging the Department of Education to implement policies to make sure all students are respected. So we pressed the department for answers about what is being done. Alex Erbal tells us what she's learned tonight. Alex.
Aloha, Howard. I met with a spokesperson for the Department of Education, and she told me they have been working on guidelines for at least 6 months, but they told me they couldn't answer specific questions about the student. The Kahuku High graduation ceremony has included a student performance for the last 20 years. A transgender student says she chose not to participate last year because she was told she couldn't wear the same color gown as the girls.
I wasn't able to participate. I tried to get a white gown, which is for females, and the red gowns, which for the males.
Jennea still received her diploma from the public school, but in a 7-minute video published Wednesday, she says her principal would talk to her about being a boy. That video is being shared with a petition asking the Hawaii Department of Education to implement a policy so all transgender students are respected and protected in Hawaii schools. I met with a spokesperson for the Department of Education to ask about Jennea, the petition, and the department's plans to implement a policy for the next school year.
The allegations about the gown are not true, as well as the allegations that she was discriminated against.
What gain and what benefit would this young transgender woman have to subject herself to the scrutiny and the judgments of the community, knowing what will come?
Hina Wong Kalu is a Native Hawaiian transgender woman. Her story is also shared with the Kumahina Project, which is behind the petition.
When you are put down because this is your personal articulation and expression of yourself, you question everything else that you do.
The Department of Education tells me it is establishing guidelines that could be implemented next school year that would cover bathroom use along with student records if a student changes his or her identity while in school.
Will teachers and counselors receive some type of mentoring or training so they know how to address issues that might come up? Yes, there have been some complexes that have already held their own type of training within dealing with various students.
I also reached out to the vice chairman of the Board of Education, who tells me the board will continue to ensure that there is a prompt investigation of any complaint. Existing Board of Education policy states a student shall not be excluded from participation in any program, services, or activity of the Department of Education. Alex Serval, KHON2 News.